Hey everybody, CW here, Card Wolf, because I am always on the hunt for great cards. And today is Friday, that means it is time for Dorking with Dice on Ice. That's right, a full box of hockey, vintage hockey packs await us today. And we just kind of dip in here and get whatever we want out of here. I think that's how it works.
Not exactly.
That's not how it works?
No.
Pack opening machine is here to explain how Dorking with Dice works. Thank you. Take over, pack opening machine. Let us know.
So, we will roll this dice, and if we got, like, a 7 or something, there are 20 packs in here and 20 sides on this dice, and if we got a 7, we'd open pack 7 in here, and 1, 10, and 20 are special packs, and we will show them to you before the video starts. 17 is also a special pack, just because we roll 17 a lot. And we will not show 17 to you.
Okay. All right. Well, that is an excellent summary of how Dorking with Dice works. And that is exactly what we are going to do today. 20 packs, 20 sides to the die. Pack opening machine knows exactly how it works. Pack opening machine opens the packs and also rolls the big pink D20 and does an excellent job at it. And I'm showing you pack 2, 6, and 17. Is that what you said?
No. I said 1, 10, and 20.
Oh, 1, 10, and 20. Okay, well, I'll show you those. What do we have here? In the number one spot, it is, I believe, 1989 Tops. Yes, there it is. 1989 Tops. Pull ourselves a Joe Sakic rookie would be pretty awesome. Lots of other great Hall of Famers and rookies in there. In the number 10 spot this week, I'm putting a repeat in from last week because everybody liked this pack so much. I got a lot of nice comments on Dynagon Ice, and people liked it a lot, so I thought I'll put this one of these back in there. It's in the number 10 spot, and these are beautiful cards, 5 cards per pack, and a ton of different inserts possible to pull out of there. And back here in the number 20 spot is our oldest pack in the box, and one of the oldest packs that we have ever opened on any version of Dorking with Dice. It is 1978 Topps Hockey, looking for a Mike Bossy rookie out of here, and that would be a very exciting pack to get into, one that I've had for a long time, and one that would be pretty neat. A lot of Hall of Famers in there. Different set of Hall of Famers in that pack than would be in the 89 pack, that's for sure. But very good ones. So now we juggle the dice? Is that what we do?
No.
What happens next?
It.
Oh, we roll it. Okay, very good. So what's our first number here? It is 16. Let's count backwards from 20. There's 19... 18, 17, and 16. This is a good one. This is Upper Deck 1993-94 Series 1 Hockey. And you see the great one on the front there. Wayne Gretzky, of course. Get 12 cards in this pack. Lots of inserts in here. We're looking for Gretzky's great ones. And this is a retail pack. So you have the exclusive insert of NHL's best, which is actually a very nice insert to pull. So I hope we get one of those. 1993-94 Upper Deck is our first pack on Dorking with Dice.
This feels
on
like
ice.
Foil or a trash bag or something.
It is a foil pack because that is what Upper Deck encased their cards in back in those days. And I've threatened many, many times to bake a potato in one of their foil packs because they're quite thick. That one looks even thicker than usual.
Yeah,
man, that is tough. Let me have a look at that. Oh, you got it. Nice. Well done, sir. Pack opening machine got into that one and is removing the cards, ripping it right down the middle. That's what we like to see, and those cards come right out for us. All right, 93-94 Upper Deck, and we start off here with Tyler Wright. And very clean-looking cards, as you can see. These are not super overly designed cards or anything like that. There's the back of them, and he played for Team Canada. And then here we've got Nicholas Anderson, who looks as though he just was hit in an uncomfortable place, if we look at the picture on the back. How does he look on the front there?
He looks like, on the back, he looks like he's itchy.
He looks like he's itchy?
Yeah, that's what I think.
Oh, yeah, maybe he is. That's a really good point, pack opening machine. That's a rookie stars, NHL star rookie, so that is a rookie of Mr. Anderson. This is Kelly Kisio, and this is Team Point Leaders? And he is the team point leader for the Sharks there. So we're getting some inserts and And interesting cards right off the top here. I'm just going to flip these over because they're kind of a little bit sticking together. Not too bad. Travis Green from the Islanders and Greg Adams there from the Canucks. Shout out to Rob at Bucks in six. Louis DeBrusque there as he... And this guy's doing a split on the ice.
Whoa there.
Yeah, whoa there indeed. It's Theo Fleury. It's a pretty nice card there. And there he is attacking the goalie. Is that... I don't think... This 92-93. I don't know who that goalie is. It's not Billy Smith. I know that. But it's... it's an Oilers goalie. I thought it was an Islanders goalie, but it is an Oilers goalie. I guess that could be... I don't think that's Grant Fuhr at that point either. I'm not sure who that is at that point. Pat Falloon from the Sharks as well. We've got several Sharks players in here, and there's Christian Rutu from the Blackhawks. Flip this over because it's an Upper Deck product, so everything's got to be backwards and forwards and upside down. It's Steve Thomas. There's an Islanders player. Puck there. Thank you for pointing that out. There's the puck. Looks like he doesn't know where it is. He's just kind of, I don't know. Doesn't look like he's going to be able to connect with that. And then here are our last two cards, if I can carefully pull these apart. We've got Cliff Ronning from the Canucks as well. And he looks like he's gritting his teeth, bracing for impact there.
Bang.
And then our last one out of that pack is another star rookie. It's Chris Simon from Quebec. Or I think the Canadiens call it Quebec.
It looks like there's something on his hockey puck that he's trying to get off.
Oh yeah, maybe something on his stick. Maybe got some ice stuck on there or something like that. I think you may be right. I'm going to put Theo Fleury on top. That was the best card out of that pack, in my opinion. Let's see what our second pack is going to be today on Dorking with Dice on Ice. It's number 10.
Yes.
Nice roll. Look at that. Number 10 pack is this sweet Dynagon Ice pack. I think we opened one of these last week. It was either last week or the week before. I can't remember now. My memory is a blur. I think it was last week. And these are beautiful cards. Lots of inserts. I'll show you the list on the back here. I'll not read through them again. I did last time, and there are quite a lot there, and we're not in focus, so you can't see what they are. But there you go. You can always pause that if you want to see for yourself what the inserts and odds are. This Dynagon Ice came out in 98-99, and some really good cards in there. We pulled a Gretzky out of the last pack we opened, so I'm hoping we pull something even better out of this one. I don't think we got any inserts out of the last pack. I think it was all, if I'm remembering right, it was all base. So hopefully this pack... we'll have an insert. We'll see how that goes. It's Darren Turcotte starts off this pack for us. Darren Turcotte right there. And he is with the Predators. We got Mike Greer coming at us here. And really pretty cards. I'm glad that actually that was reversed because the backs are actually quite nice too. The fronts are beautiful. And they did a nice job on the back as well. There he is, Mike Greer. And Adam Deadmarsh with the Avalanche. Next card is Tom Pody, and that is a rookie card. It is not an insert, and he's got something stuck in his mouth there. I don't know what that is. Maybe he's eating a piece of chocolate. You think that's like half a chocolate bar he's got crammed in there?
He has a mouth guard.
No, that makes too much sense. Pack opening machine with the logic, as always. And our last card is Patrick Marleau, and there you go. We're getting a lot of sharks today. I don't know what's up with that.
It's possible that he has the hockey puck in his mouth.
Oh yeah, that's totally what's going on there. He just got hit in the mouth with the hockey puck, and he just decided he's going to keep it in there.
Maybe he has a black tongue.
Maybe he does. What animal? Doesn't a giraffe have a black tongue? Maybe he's part giraffe.
Giraffes have more of a purpley tongue.
Okay. I haven't been licked by a giraffe in a long time, so my memory's a little hazy on that.
My cousin has been.
Has he? Okay. I'll have to talk to him about that.
It was a girl.
It's one of your girl cousins?
Yeah. All right,
I'll have to talk to her about that. All right, there we go. That was beautiful cards, but not as exciting of a pack as I had hoped. The last pack we opened was a good one. All right, what's our third pack today? It is 17. Wow, you're rolling really, really well,
two
pack opening machine.
Packs on a row.
Nice job. All right, I know what 17 is. That is this pack right here. It's 1988, or 1998, rather. 1998-99 Omega NHL. And once it's in focus, you'll be dazzled, I'm sure. And these are nice cards. Six cards per pack here, and also many, many inserts. This is another Pacific product, and I will get those inserts in focus for you. I don't know what is going on with my camera right now.
What
is even happening here? There's nothing else on the screen for it to focus on. There we go.
Finally.
All right. So anyway, there's a look. Blurry though it may be, there's a look at the some of the inserts, and there's a lot of cards. I'm going to just hand this to you. Rip into that, and let's see what we get out of these Omega cards from $98.99. So the last pack we opened was also $98.99, and the Dynagon Ice are pretty. These are also pretty, but very different. So I'm going to hold these up so that you can kind of see. You know, these definitely have kind of a similar feel to them, I think. They're both sort of got that Pacific feel where they're designed really well, but very different and also very nice. So I'm excited to get into these. Martin Straka starts things off from the Penguins, and you see the player there in the middle, and then their strange futuristic silver portrait there. That's kind of
weird.
It's a little weird and creepy, but anyway, we got Jeff Hackett there, the goalie for the Canadiens. And flipped us over. Garth Snow, another goalie card for us from the Canucks. And then we got a rookie card of Lubos Barteco from the Blues, and Marty Reasoner as well. So two Blues rookies there in the back of that. You get a close-up look at those two young men. We flip this over. We got Martin Rusinski there from the Canadiens. And we finish off with Miroslav Satin, or I don't think it's Satan. I think it's Satan. I think it was Satan, Miroslav Satan, I think is his last name. And there you go. So, again, not a great pack. I don't think I've pulled a single thing that I have even been considering putting into the Wolf Lair. So we're going to have to roll a good pack and just see if we can get some Hall of Famers or something out of there. Pack number 11. So that was 17. We opened 16. That's 15, 14, 13, 12, and 11. And this is indeed what I put in the 11th spot. I just organized this box moments ago, and this is a good pack too. I don't know if we've opened this on the channel before. It is 95-96 Series 1 Tops. There are chase cards randomly inserted and a new to the game card in every pack. Now, some of those are rookie cards and some of them are not. I'll let Pack Opening Machine do the honors there. Pretty sure we have not opened this pack before on the channel, so I'm excited to get into these. 95-96 Tops Hockey. If you're enjoying this episode, thank you so much. Please hit the thumbs up. It does wonderful things for the channel, and I really appreciate it. Thank you so much again for coming by the channel. Hope you guys have great weekend plans, and whatever you may have planned, I hope it goes well for you. I think we're done with the snow finally here, so we went sledding and had a snowball battle last weekend, which I'm still recovering from, but it was a lot of fun, and not all the snow, but a lot of the snow has melted at this point, so we will not be doing that. Is that another foil pack? Is that giving you some trouble there?
Mm-hmm.
All right, let me get it started for you. So I think
I've got it.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
You need to break out your Wolverine claws and go at that. I think that would maybe help the situation. There you go.
Okay, then.
There you go. I think you got it. All right. So let's show some cards here. People are wondering what's happening on this channel. Man, I'm not going to get any more of these Topps 95-96 packs. They're too hard to get into. All right, here we go. We start off with another Canucks player. It is really hard to read these. It's Brett Hedekin. And I'll get these in focus for you so you can check them out, too. These are nice cards. I mean, they kind of, it's not quite the Stadium Club treatment, but it definitely has sort of that feel to it that's got the very big pictures and what do we have here? Marquee men, so that's a nice insert. It's Mikael Renberg from the Flyers.
There it is,
marquee men. So pretty card there, and I'll show you the back. We got two in a row? Come on. I thought we were done with that kind of nonsense.
And they're duplicates.
Yes, that's what I mean. They're duplicates. Thought we were done with that. Duplicate marquee men. Oh, man, I thought we were done with that. Nice Patrick Roy card here. That's pretty sweet. Like to see that. That's our best card. That's the only one I'm putting in the Wolf Lair so far today. Paul Kariya, that's a pretty good one, too. Maybe I'll put that in there. I believe that is a rookie card of that player, and he is a pretty good player there. Maybe I'll put that one in there, too. That's a nice rookie. Here we got Power from the Philadelphia Flyers. Power Lines is what this insert is, and that's pretty sweet. I wish it had the names of the players. I believe it will tell us on back. It's Lindros LeClaire and Mikael Renberg, so that's pretty nice. And there is Mikael Renberg. That's our third Mikael Renberg card in this pack. What is even going on? I thought we were done with this kind of duplication. That seems to only happen on my channel. I do not understand it. It's a pretty card, though. Nice Lindros. I guess I'll Wolf Lair that, too. Why not? So what do we have here? This is Kenny Johnson from the Leafs. And they're not sticky. They're just a little hard to get to come apart there. Richard Park skating for the Penguins. And this one is actually a bit sticky. No, it's just, they just kind of have that glossy. Scott Niedermeyer, that's a pretty good card, too. He's up against the boards there, crushing some poor, it looks like Capitals player. I'm not sure. It's red. I guess it could be the Devils, but I don't know. He's crushing somebody up against the boards there. Well, Niedermeyer's with the Devils, so that's not it. He wouldn't crush his own guy. So I guess it's a Caps player. From the Oilers, it is Marco Tuominen there. I can't remember that player very well. And here's a nice one. This is new to the game. We were promised one of these cards. And indeed, a Stars player greets us. It's Mike Kennedy. He looks very eager and anxious. And he looks pumped there. Look at Mike Kennedy showing the emotion. Nobody else in the stands seems to care what's going on, but he looks pumped about something. Another Oilers player, it's Luke Richardson there. He looks like he's battling for the puck. And our last card out of the pack is Jim Carrey, the comedian who part-timed goalied for the, who is that? The Caps. Yep, didn't know Jim Carrey played goalie for the Caps, but there he is. And he looks a lot different, no question. He doesn't look like the same guy at all, but it's the same guy. That was his rookie season, actually. He got done doing Dumb and Dumber, and then he went and did goalie for the Caps. So there you go. Are we going to do another? Oh, I see the pack opening machine reaching for the die. So I guess we're doing another one. I'm going to put this over here. Actually, got some decent cards out of there.
Okay, that needs to be better.
All right, that's better. We already hit 17, so better still. There you go. That was a really good roll, actually. 13. All right, 13. I've kind of lost track of where we are. Did we open... What was the last number we rolled? Do you remember?
I can't recall.
Yeah, so I'm kind of lost here. I think it was 11? I'm not sure.
Yeah, it was 11.
Was it 11? All right, so I'm just going to open... I'm actually not sure where we are in the box at this point, so I'm just going to open one of the... I think this is 13. Because that would have been 12, and this would have been 13, I believe, is what we're looking at here.
Okay.
So you can open that one. It is, sorry, I didn't show it very well on the camera. I got to do that. Yeah. It's Score 1991, Series 1, English version. And this has a lot of cards in it, 15 cards, so that will be a lot of fun. As I recall, that also gives us the possibility of getting an autographed Bobby Orr card, which I've never pulled from Score. And it makes me suspect that the... the autographed Bobby Orr cards don't actually exist. That Score just
this
kind
is,
of said that.
Trash bag.
Yeah, those wrappers are just like trash bags. We start off with someone who I believe is a Hall of Famer and certainly should be if he isn't. It's Dino Cicerelli, who there is with the Capitals, but he started off his career, I believe, with... Was it the North Stars? I can't remember now. You'd think it would say so, but it doesn't. Oh, well. One of you, I'm sure, will inform me in the comments if I have that right. I know he didn't start off with the Caps. He played for a long time for somebody else. I think it was the North Stars. There's Brian Bellows, longtime NHLer himself, and he played for several different teams. Tom Barrasso, we're pulling some good cards out of here. Some guys who definitely had good careers in the NFL, NHL rather. Good goalie there with the Penguins. Tom Fergus, looking curious and anxious at the same time for Toronto. Charlie Huddy, skating for the Oilers, Bob Basson, and Dmitry Krishtich for the Caps. We got Mike Craig for the North Stars. No Sharks out of this pack. We got a lot of Sharks today, but not out of this one, because in 1991 they weren't around. Troy Millett there for New York, and Tom Curvers, another Canucks card. We got Brad McCrimmon, good NHLer as well there with the Red Wings. Paul Fenton for Calgary. And Rick Vave, he played for a long time, and I think he might be in the Hall of Fame as well. Rick Vave played for Buffalo and several other teams. John Ogrodnik, there for the Rangers, good player for them. And Bobby Smith, perhaps one of the best North Stars players ever. We got like 5 North Stars out of that pack. Bobby Smith, really good player for them for quite a few years. And look how happy he is on the back. He just looks delighted. And he has all his teeth, too, which is always a plus. You don't see that a lot with hockey players, so we'll Wolf Lair that one. And that brings us to the close of today's Dorking with Dice on Ice episode. Thank you so much for coming out to the show today, and thank Pack Opening Machine for all of your assistance. I could never have done this without you. And I'm greeted by silence. All right. You guys have a great weekend, and I will see you back here on Monday for a Mail Day episode. I have not decided which piece of mail I'm going to open. I have several sitting here, which is awesome, and some of them are from you wonderful people, which I always appreciate. So see what I decide to open on Monday. Should be a lot of fun. See you back here then. Have a great weekend, and as always, happy collecting.